Welcome to all of you. We will spend here around 1.5 hours to tell you a little about a citizen consultation project on the issues that are discussed in here. This citizen consultation went on in 38 countries. We had 44 meetings in 38 countries, covered all continents. We covered low-income, growth economies, and industrialized rich countries. There were 100 citizens at each meeting, at each consultation for one day. And they answered, voted on 12 questions, and they made their own recommendations. This is, in a nutshell, what happened in the worldwide views of global warming. But we will tell you about this project, we will tell you about the results, and later we will have a panel debate here. So I just want to say that we have been very lucky to have a good panel. I hope you agree with me. We have three citizens from the meetings. Ligian Lam from Vietnam, Merit El Saif from Egypt, and Andrea Vatum from Norway. So they will tell about their experiences from being part of such a global citizen consultation. Then we will have our foreign minister, our minister of development, Mrs. Ulla Ternes, in the panel too. We have Mrs. Ferle van der Weer, who is the director of the climate unit in UNDP. And then we have Nitin Desai, who is a member of the Indian Prime Minister's Council on Climate Change and the former Undersecretary General for Economic and Social Affairs at UN. And we have Mr. Bo Chilin, who was a chief climate negotiator for Sweden at the Kyoto process, and now he is advisor for the Swedish EU presidency. And they will get some time later to give comments to the project. But before that, you will see a documentary, and you will hear about the results that the citizens made. I want to tell you a little about why we made such a citizen consultation on climate change. I'm the director of the Danish Board of Technology, and this is an advisory unit for the Danish government and the Danish parliament on scientific and technological issues. You could say the relationships between science, technology, and society. That's what we advise about. And we're seeing increasingly that the issues we're advising about, they are moving upwards. Up to transnational level, global level, and of course the reason is that the problems policies are facing are increasingly getting cross-border. So our problem is, that means it moves out of the embracement of advisors, it moves out of the embracement of public debate, it even moves out of the embracement of the media. We have no real global media. So our thought was, is it possible to make to bridge this gap between the citizens, what goes on in the public, which the considerations in the public, and the discussion at the policy level? So we developed Worldwide Views on Global Change to try to do that, because we thought that climate change would be a very good issue to try to do this for the first time. I think what the Worldwide Views of Global Warming has made is a very unique result. It's unique in many ways. Compared to polls, the citizens who were involved in this project were informed. They got informed before they answered the questions. It's not a telephone call where you get disturbed in the middle of your supper with a child on your one arm and the meat boiling in the kitchen. You get the citizens here, they were well prepared, well informed when they answered the questions. They had time to discuss with each other. The results from the Worldwide Views of Global Warming are the answers from this considered views from the citizens, you could say. I also think it is unique, the results are unique in another way. They are not about what people think about IPCC and their results, or what people feel that there is climate change what we asked them about is exactly the same thing that are being negotiated at COP50. So we simply asked them about the policy issues directly. And I think that is very neat to have answers about that.